Hello, welcome back to another blog read with me, Jack, from rheumatology.physio. And this week we are doing something quite different. We're going to talk about polymyalgia rheumatica and physiotherapy. So it's a bit of a new approach to the blog this week in a couple of different ways. I'm adding two new features, legend of the blog. And if you scroll all the way to the bottom, you can listen to the music I was listening to when I wrote this. And at the end of this little podcast, I will play a little sample of the music. So hopefully we all enjoy that, and it's a little bit of an interesting difference. So my polymyalgia rheumatica blog, which was very popular, and I decided to follow it up after continued Twitter conversations. I've done a rudimentary literature search, and I've outlined that below and what I've learned. I hope that it serves to help understanding where we are, or even someone more intelligent than I, to start publications. Please consider heading to the shop, rheumatology.physio/shop, to find more resources and supporting me to continue this harebrained project. As usual, feedback is greatly appreciated, and any further reading for me, please send it my way. Please remember, this blog is not a replacement for clinical reasoning, and if you are unsure, get advice. So on to legend of the blog. This week's legend is the endurance physio himself, Mike James. He has some cool new sessions targeted at runners on recovery, and so on that we can signpost them all to him. More than that, he has helped me out on a number of occasions, so please do check him out on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. If you just type in the endurance physio, he usually pops up. On to the blog. Introduction. Polymyalgia rheumatica is primarily managed with steroids, NSAIDs, and DMARDs. I've seen a few of these patients attend physio for restoration of function, range of motion and strength usually, or for bone protection due to the risks of the steroids. It never particularly occurred to me that physio evidence would be lacking. It's pretty decent in rheumatoid and axial spondyloarthritis, until of course I realised that from a pathophysiological point of view, PMR is still a bit of a mystery. Then I realised there was nothing available for me to use as an evidence base. Anyway, following the blog previous, there were a few tweets regarding guidelines for PMR and physiotherapy. I thought there was very little, but I didn't know, so here we are. I looked. I've put the search strings at the bottom of the blog, which you can find on the website, so you can recreate what I did if you so wish. Guidelines. 2015 EULAR/ACR guidelines. That's open access, the link is in the blog, but if you just type in EULAR polymyalgia rheumatica guidelines, it does come up at the top. Recommendation 9. The panel conditionally recommends considering an individualized exercise program for PMR patients aimed at the maintenance of muscle mass and function, and reducing the risk of falls. There are no studies investigating the value of non-pharmacological therapies, e.g. physiotherapy, relaxation techniques, diets, etc., in PMR, and there is insufficient clinical experience on this issue to agree on a specific recommendation. Nevertheless, the panel agreed on recommending an individualised exercise program in view of its benefit for maintaining muscle mass and function and reducing risk of falls, especially in older persons on long-term glucocorticoids as well as in frail patients. And then they wrote in their research agenda, what is the value of non-pharmacological therapies in PMR? Particularly, it is assumed but not yet demonstrated that physiotherapy may support preservation of function and reduce the risk of adverse events related to glucocorticoid use. Patients may benefit from exercise by maintaining muscle mass and function, as well as by fall prevention, especially in the frail. Also, what is the role of the diet in PMR and nutrition supplements, e.g. fish oil, related to outcomes? I also looked at the BSR and BHPR guidelines, but they do not mention therapy other than medical. It's very honest to the guidelines, in my opinion, taking a best punt, consensus, that physiotherapy might be of some assistance offsetting the problems incurred by steroids, systemic inflammation and loss of function. The search. I went to PubMed, and again, you can see what I did right at the bottom of the blog. Initially, I just searched the titles for polymyalgia rheumatica as a reference point. 1,766 results. Excellent. One of those has to be about physio, surely. Nope. Polymyalgia rheumatica and physiotherapy, 0 results. Polymyalgia rheumatica and physical therapy, 0 results. I expanded the searches to include the abstract and finally got 5 and 2 results respectively, but none were relevant in any way except one from 1994. Therapeutic modalities. such as physical therapy, medications, and surgery, should be modified sometimes to accommodate age-related changes in body mechanics and function. But I can't access the full article to read more specifically. The reference to that is Nesha G, Moore TL, Clinical Presentation and Treatment of Arthritis in the Aged. If someone can get a hold of that, I'd be very grateful to read it. So where are we? Okay, this seems problematic. We can make some assumptions, I think. Physiotherapy for bone density and falls risk should be effective in PMR patients. I'm not sure muscle mass has been shown to improve with strengthening programs in inflammatory conditions specifically, but function certainly has. So again, I think we're on steady ground here. Clearly, we can't say physio helps PMR specifically. We also can't currently say that it will be tolerated, which I think is problem number one. Tolerance, I think, is a priority here to build further research off the back of. When, why, and how follows that. I look forward to seeing some of that research take place, and I'm happy to discuss that further with anyone keen. End. I hope this has been interesting. The search string's at the bottom of the webpage, and if anyone has any specific questions around PMR and physio, I'm happy to try and answer them. I think I'll do a video and a podcast about specifically what I would do with these polymyalgia rheumatica patients and be a bit more specific. Please do get me any feedback you might have so that I can grow and improve, and I will see you next time. So finally, the music choice for this blog is Bring Me the Horizon, Medicine, and a couple of lyrics from the start which I like. Some people are a lot like clouds, you know, because life's so much brighter when they go. So we're going to listen to approximately 10 seconds of that so we don't get into copyright trouble, and I hope that you'll go and find that on Spotify or YouTube and listen to the rest of it, because it is a really good song. And I will see you out on the next blog recording.
Some people are a lot like clouds, you know, 'cause life's so much brighter when they go. You rained on my heart for far too long. Couldn't see the thunder for the storm. Because I cut my teeth and bit my tongue till my mouth was dripping blood.